Hi everybody, my name is Maddie, and today I will be showing you how to make Bay Crocker's molasses cookies. Now, what you'll need is one medium-sized bowl, one plate, one 12-inch cookie sheet, one strip of parchment paper, one fork, and one tablespoon. If you prefer, you can put your ingredients into separate bowls. For example, I have a small bowl for my butter, however, I do not have a bowl for my egg. And this is just something that I do, but I have a bowl that has all my trash in it. So when I'm cooking, I can easily just put it into my trash bowl. And then later, after when I'm cooking, I can throw it all in the trash. And it's a very easy, quick, clean cleanup. Now, before we do anything else, we are going to preheat the oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. Now that we have preheated the oven, the last thing that we need to do before we can get into the ingredients is pull your hair back, want to keep clean, and right after that, go wash your hands. Now that your hands are all nice and clean and your hair is back on the top of your head, now we can start grabbing the ingredients. So, like I said, you're going to want a bag mix of Bay Crocker's molasses cookies. You need a bag of sugar. You can use Domino's or any type of brand that you enjoy. You're going to need some water for the tablespoon of water that you'll eventually use. And you'll need one singular egg. Now, what I like to do is I start with my wet ingredients first. So, we're going to start off, we're going to put all of everything else aside. We're going to start off with one tablespoon of water. The egg. Okay, throw that egg right in your trash bin. Look how easy that was. Now, since I touched an egg, however, don't want salmonella poisoning, so I'm going to go back over and go wash your hands again. Can't be too safe. Now, you take your softened stick of butter and just pop that in there. Finally, you're going to add in the cookie dough mix. Open that up. Whenever I am making cookies or a cake with a pre-made dry mix, I always put half of the mixture into the bowl. I stir it up and then I add the rest of the half once I get to a good consistency. I just find it makes it easier to stir. So you're going to want to stir this all together. And it's a little bit harder because it is molasses cookies. There's only one tablespoon of water, butter, and an egg. So there's not a lot of wet goods in here or wet ingredients in here to really be able to easily stir it up. So if you need to use a blender, go ahead and use a blender. But I'm just going to mix all together with my fork. What I find easiest is doing the circle motion. Kind of just grab all the dough, gotta scrape it off the sides, make sure you don't miss anything, and I push down. I try to break up any of the clumps of butter that there may be. But I don't want to over stir it. There's such a thing as overstirring. So the first half has mixed very nicely. Now add in the last of the cookie dough mix and try to mix that now all together. Into the trash pile it goes. Look at how easy that is, you know? All right, and you just stir it all in. Especially with a cookie dough mix that's this dry, it's very easy for the powder to just kind of fly everywhere. So you don't really need to go fast. It is molasses cookies, so you can go as slow as molasses. Sorry for the terrible pun. and keep your eye on your dry ingredients. Try to get all the dry mixture into the wet mixture. What I'm doing is kind of making it into a ball, really. I don't even mean to, but the way that I mix it kind of forces it to.
In the end, you're going to want your mixture to look like this. See, that consistency is very hard to pull up, but not too hard.
Now what you're going to want to do is take that tablespoon, go in there, fill it up, push it over, take off any of the excess. Don't want to make your cookies too big or they'll when they cook, they'll meld into each other. So it's about that shape. And all you do is you roll it. And you don't even have to roll it for that long. You just want to get this type of kind of sheen and this kind of just smoothness everywhere. As you can see from a different ball I made, they're basically the same shape, and that's the type of look that you want on them. The last step is that you're going to cover one side of the plate that you put all your little cookie balls onto. You're going to cover that in sugar. You don't need a whole lot of sugar. Just about so. What this is going to be for is you're going to take the cookie ball and then you're going to roll it in the sugar. You're going to make a nice little covering of sugar for the molasses cookies. I'm going to make rows of 4 by 3. So going to roll all these cookies, and then afterwards we'll put them in the oven, and for 375 the oven's already beat, so it's ready, and they'll be ready in 8 to 10 minutes. Keep it probably like good 2-finger distance away. Both sides, top two. Now you can put them in the oven. And those are molasses cookies from Betty Crocker. And when you take them off the stove, you're going to want to let them cool for about 1 minute, and then you can get them ready to get served. It goes great with a glass of milk. And I really hope you enjoy this video, and I hope you enjoy your molasses cookies. All right, enjoy. Thank you. And here they are, Bay's Crockers molasses cookies. They're delicious. They're super duper great. So, dunk them in milk. And have a...
Oh, that was fantastic.
Gotta watch that.